Thank you. Sorry, I'm new to iPad, so like, thank you all so much for joining me at my junior recital, whether you're here in person or tuning in from the live stream. The first piece I just play is what's the Ballade in D flat major by American composer Amy Beach. This piece is a concert fantasy on her art song on Robert Burns' poem, A Red, Red Rose. And today I selected three pieces that all have really deep connections to human emotions. So this is a part of it. So the poem is about this person. He can't reach the person he really loves. So no matter how hard he tries to reach it, he can never reach it. So that really reminds me of the past four years, wow, COVID was 4 years ago, when I was far away from my parents and I couldn't go home as often as I used to be. And you're there as close as, you know, a video call from WeChat, but I can't go home as often because of travel restrictions. I love this piece, the variety this piece offers. I love the beautiful melodies at the beginning and also the more intense sections that shows off the intense range of the piano. And the next piece I will be playing is Beethoven's Piano Sonata No. 30, Opus 109. And this is one of my favorite Beethoven sonatas. And I want to share a really short story that I have with this piece. It's also COVID related. So in the summer of 2021, I went back to China and I had to quarantine in a hotel for 14 days. And it was really hard because you're not allowed to leave your room at all, like a foot out of the room. So I was just really lonely because I was alone. And every day I would just play this piece on my phone, and it really makes me feel better about those quarantine days. Opus 109 is one of the three latest sonatas that Beethoven wrote, and I really like how, you know, like a classical sonata form is usually like 6 minutes, but in this piece, Beethoven gives you two of that examples in 6 minutes. It really shows how economic, you know, a sonata form could be. And then the third movement is a theme and variation with the original chorales transformed in the next six variations. It not only just added embellishment to the original theme, but it also transformed the character of the original theme to different extremes, and it really shows the complexity of human emotions. And I feel like this piece is just like you have to play many times throughout your life, and I don't think I lived long enough to give a speech about human, like a life experience, but you know, this is the start of my life experience, and I am really excited to share this piece with you. Thank you.
Thank you.
Before I talk about the next piece, I would like to say a few thank yous. First, I want to thank Alvina, Lawrence Recording Services, and Brent for making my recital run so smoothly. I know I changed my recital date like a million times, and you know I was honored with the most changes of the event listing in the piano department, but just thank you so much for making everything possible and being so flexible. I want to especially shout out to the wonderful usher, Sarah Pedler, who is my former roommate, and the stage manager, Henry Giles, who is my homie. I want to thank my friends, my piano studio, my family, my parents for always being so supportive. I want to thank all my past teachers and mentors for encouraging me to continue making music. Among them, I really want to thank my high school music teachers, Julie and Neil Freeburn, for encouraging me to keep studying music, because on Facebook today, I got a memory that 5 years ago, I played at a Calliope concert at my high school, and I performed this piece I learned the week before. It didn't go really well, but you know, we learned lessons along the way, and it's just really, I don't know, it feels really different to see how far I've been from then. Lastly, I want to thank Professor Padilla for his guidance throughout the past 2 years, and thank you for always being there for me, being so caring and supportive, giving me, you know, counseling sessions during my lesson. I'm really grateful for all of that, and I don't know if I'll continue studying piano without your support. Okay, the next piece, The Higden Pale Yellow. A lot of people know I'm obsessed with coffee, and I always associate music with coffee, not because you don't get enough sleep from practicing, so you need coffee to stay awake, but like coffee, music also has colors, and the coffee's color is reflected through, you know, the roast level, the combination of acidity, sweetness, you know, the grinder you use, whatever. So now the question is, can music reflect colors, and can colors be reflected through music, and how do we reflect those colors? American composer Jennifer Higden has her answers, and she has the program notes, and she said, "In my composing, I often picture colors as I were spreading them on a canvas, except I do so with melodies, harmonies, and through the instruments themselves. The colors that I have chosen in both of the movement titles and in the music itself reflect very different mood and energy levels, which I find fascinating, and it begs the question, can colors actually convey a mood?" In Pale Yellow, Jennifer Higden used one of the most popular chamber ensemble, the piano trio, to reflect the color pale yellow. As I'm working on this piece, I often think, you know, like with the pale yellow, how will the coffee made of pale yellow taste like? And I welcome you to think about this question as we perform this piece for you. And I did not forget. Lastly, I want to thank Nick and Ben for collaborating with me on this piece. It's been such a fun time working on the piece with you guys. And thank you so much to Professor George, Professor Mizrahi, and Professor Padilla for coaching us on this piece and giving us feedbacks. I hope you all enjoy Pale Yellow by Jennifer Higden, and thank you so much for coming to my recital.